Hi friends, this is Dr. Shakil Sheikh and we are going to discuss how to identify the pteridophytes. As we know that the plant system has a simple classification based on the availability of the seeds. Those plants who make or prepare the seeds and those who cannot make the seeds. Flowering and non-flowering plants. Those plants which are making the seeds, they are also again comes under the two categories, that is the plants which produces the flowers known as the gymnosperms. Gymnosperm cannot produce the flowers, whereas the plants which are produce the flowers are known as the angiosperms. Where in the next category, that is those do not make the seeds, they may be also categorized into different categories, that is those who has no true roots, stems or the leaves, then those who has no roots, stems or the leaves are categorized under the algae, whereas some of them has some roots, stems or the leaves, these are comes under the class, that is mosses. And in the same, that is those don't make the seeds, has the roots, stems and the leaves, they comes under the pteridophytes. The plant kingdom system in advanced manner has to be known as, we know that non-vascular plants and the vascular plants depends upon the tissues which are containing. So non-vascular plants, as we know that the bryophytes, they are again divided into liverworts, hornworts and the mosses. While in case of the vascular plants, these are under categories of spore producing plants, that is the pteridophytes, and seed producing plants, that is the spermatophytes. The pteridophytes are again categorized into club mosses, hostels and ferns, whereas the seed producing plants are again divided into two categories, that is the non-flowering plants and the flowering plants. So non-flowering plants, example is the gymnosperms, and the flowering plants are the, we call them as a most advanced group of the plants, that is the angiosperms. In gymnosperms, again it is divided into conifers, cycads and ginkgo. So these are the some categories under non-flowering plants of the gymnosperms. While in case of the angiosperm, plants with one seeded leaf, that is we call them as a monocots or monocotyledons, and the plants with the two seed leaves, those are called the dicots or dicotyledons. Out of these, today we will discuss more about the pteridophytes. So what are the pteridophytes? Pteron, that means the feeder like structure, and phyton is nothing but the plant. So this can constitute the most primitive seedless vascular plants that reproduce by means of the spores. These are the first true land plants that evolved after bryophytes. They are called as botanical snakes or snakes of the plant kingdom. They are also called as amphibians of the plant kingdom, because like bryophytes, they depend on an external source of water for the fertilization. Now what are the salient features of the pteridophytes? These are the first true land plants. They are seedless, vascular cryptogams. The life cycle of the pteridophyte is heterologous diplohaplontic type, Sporophyte is the dominant plant body, while the gametophyte is small, simple and prothallus. The sporophyte of pteridophytes has a two roots, stem and the leaves. In the xylem, trachea, that is the vessels, absent, and in phloem, companion cells are absent. Pteridophytes are producing the spores which develop in sporangia, which are homosporous or heterosporous in nature. Sporangia are produced in groups. This structure is known as sori, and these sori are produced on the sporophylls. The young leaves of the sporophyte show succinate vernation or succinate taxis. Gametophyte develops small sessile antheridia and partially embedded archegonia with four-rowed neck. The sex organs are multicellular and jacket. Now, when we came towards the identification of the pteridophytes, for example, Adiantum, this is known as a walking fern or maidenhair fern. There are near about 250 species, and these are producing the horseshoe shaped sori on the lower surface of the leaflets. They are with dark, often black stripes and rachises, and bright green, often delicately cut leaf tissues. The sori are born submergedly and are covered by reflex flaps of leaf tissue, which resembles indusia. Dimorphism between sterile and fertile frond is generally subtle. They generally prefer humus-rich, moist, well-drained sites ranging from bottom line soils to vertical rock wall. Many species are especially known for growing on rock walls around waterfalls and water seepage areas. If you can see the sporangia, stalk and the head, the spores are generally tetrahedral, uninucleate with axine and intine. The next one is the Asplenium. This is commonly known as bird's nest fern. There are about 700 species occur all over the world. The common vernacular name is spleenworts. This belongs to family Asplenaceae, and the species which is shown here is Asplenium nidus. They are either as an epiphytal or terrestrial plants. Asplenium nidus forms large simple fronds visually similar to banana leaves. The large size leaves are occurred in the Asplenium nidus. This is not the case in each species of the Asplenium. They are light green, often crinkled with a black midrib, and exhibit succinate vernation. The spores of the Asplenium develop in a sori on the underside of the fronds. These sori form long rows extending out from the midrib on the back of the outer part of the lamina, that is we called as a frond. Spores are much ornamental, thick and ridged. This is very interesting fern, and the look itself shows its structure, and therefore this is known as the royal fern. Growing in the woodlands, bogs and on the banks of the streams, it is known as the flowering fern due to the appearance of its fertile frond. Usually it grows in cool, moist and shaded places such as the banks of the streams, lakes, ponds and in the forest. Each sporangium in Osmunda is traceable to a single sporangial initials. Neighboring cells also contribute to the stalk of the sporangium, either wholly or in part. If you can see the sporangium, it is pyriform in shape, reddish brown in color, and has a stout stalk. The jacket is one layer thick and has a shield or plate-like annulus. Spores are minute in size, ranging from 0.054 to 0.072 mm, and have a three-layered wall that we call as a endospore, perispore, and outermost exospore. The exospore is ornamented with spines or protuberances. The spores are chlorophyllous in nature, and therefore in initial stage it is, or those are green in color, and at the time of maturity they convert the color into yellowish to brownish or reddish in reddish brown. The next one is the blechnum. It is commonly known as hard fern. Near about 150 to 220 species of the ferns with a cosmopolitan distribution. Most of them are herbaceous plants and few are tree ferns too. Separation of the sterile, that is the photosynthetic and fertile reproductive fronts, are found in blechnum. The habitat shows terrestrial herb with the sub-erect rhizome. Stipes are tufted, dark brown at the very base, pale or gray-brown above, sparsely scaly at the base, glabrous at the above. The lamina of the blechnum is falcate-lanceolate, while the pinna are dark green in color, with glabrous above and below. The texture of the leaflet or the frond is coriaceous. Soraya produced linear along with the costa, not reaching the base and apex. Parallel spores are reniform, yellowish brown, exine with faint thin, and the reticular thickenings are also observed. Again, the next one is the ophioglossum. This is called as the adder's tongue fern. Near about 25 to 30 species of ferns are occurred, which belongs to ophioglossus. Each plant typically sends up a small undivided leaf blade with netted venation, and the spore stalks form the leaf stalk, terminating in sporangia, which are partially concealed within a structure with slitted slides. It consists of two-part fond separated into a rounded diamond-shaped sheet and narrow spore-bearing spike. So this is the structure of the ophioglossum. We can see that plant body, that is, it consists of root, rhizome, stipule, long petiole, then the lamina, and the sporangiferous spike. The spores are present in sporangia. The sporangia are produced in two rows on a fertile segment that arises at the junction of the petiole and the sterile lamina. This sporangia bearing fertile segment is known as sporangiferous spike. The ophioglossum spores are homosporous, and the haploid spores are the mother cells of the gametophytic generation. The spores are small, round, with an outer sculptured exine and inner thin intine, which germinate shortly after dispersal. So these are the some of the ferns or the pteridophytes which we can identify with their characters.